Hey y'all. Well, I wanted to share with y'all a particular subject matter. Just noticed that my little curtain has been moved by my little doggy. I have like a little canopy at my little love seat right here to make this a nice cozy area where I do Bible studies. One place I do. I have places all over the house that I do Bible studies. Sorry, I had to pick up a little bookmark that fell out of my Bible. So what I want to talk to you about is Bible study tools. I think there can be simplicity, or you can, I don't want to say make it complicated though. You can have something, just a very simple thing, or you can have added things. Let's just go over some of my ideas. And then also I want y'all to comment down below, what kind of ideas do you have about Bible study, or maybe what are the tools you use when you do Bible studies? I know some of you that are my subbies, like Sherry McGinnis. Is it Sherry or Cherie? I think it's Cherie. Because I know she's another one, you guys. Go check her out. She does some great Bible studies and tips and things like that as well. So anyway, let's get started. First and foremost, you need a Bible. And it can be a Bible that just has the text only. No study helps. No concordances. Usually most of them have a map or two in the back and the weights and measures chart. But this is just a little small pocket Bible. It is the Holy Bible NIV translation. And it's just, you can see I've been highlighting in it. It's a good size text. It fits in my purse. You can see it's all bent up and very worn out. There is a perspectives sheet or two in the back. And what it is like a baby concordance where it just has little study things like, what does the Bible have to say about baptism? And then it lists like three scriptures. And so what concordances do is they kind of amplify a subject matter, and then they show you different places, maybe in the Old and New Testament, where you can go look up that subject. And you can turn that into a Bible study. That's what I mean about keeping it simple. Like joy. Pick joy and let that be your subject matter theme for your Bible study. And then just go and look in the back and see if joy's in there, and it'll say there's 10 verses. And just go look them all up and write them down. So we'll get to that in a minute. But you can have something like that where it is just the Bible itself, or it can be one where you have study helps. And I have both, y'all. I really do. I have several Bibles that are just the Bible. And then I have several Bibles that are the Bible plus study helps, commentaries, concordances, and other type things. One that I am going to do, because I was asked to, is a review of the Thompson Chain Reference Bible. And if y'all are interested in any other one, let me know, because I love buying Bibles with different types of study helps, reviewing them for myself and also for others. But this is the She Reads Truth one. It's the one I'm using right now. Y'all know my main one that I use is a Life Application Study Bible. It has text across the bottom, not the holy text. It has notes across the bottom of how to apply that scripture to your life, or maybe some cultural relevance. And it has some chapter summaries at the front. And She Reads Truth, it's got timelines at the front, and that's what her timeline looks like, just to kind of give you a picture where this particular book is in the time of the writing and what was going on maybe in history. There's also some little checkoffs boxes right here of things that you can read from the Old Testament that apply to this New Testament book or something like that. It gives you, actually this one, this is the reading plan, week one and week two, a reading plan for this book, and this is the book of Ezra. And also at the beginning of each one of the books, she puts why we need this book in the Bible. So I think that's kind of cool. And then maybe some themes. So, and then there's decorative pages as well. Let me just show you one for this one, where she takes a scripture and just makes it pretty. So, and this, by the way, is a leatherette navy, and these tabs came from Etsy. They did not come in here, and I had to painstakingly put them on. They're hard to put on. But anyway, because the study helps, study Bibles are heavy. Here is another one. It's called the Cultural Background Study Bible, and it literally is that. There's all kinds of, like, when you're looking for a Bible, first of all, comment below if you'd like me to help you, but it'll show what the features of that Bible are, usually on the back of the box. This one, I like soft Bible better than hard Bible just because it's pliable. And my first Bible when I got born again that I got is literally held together with shipping tape because it was a hardback and I wore it out. So I do like something that is a little bit more pliable so it lasts a little longer. This is just also, it's pretty. It kind of makes it fun to come to the Bible study with yourself and the Lord. And it's got the pretty silver edging and this linen front and the leatherette green. And but it's got tons of study helps at the bottom to the point it's almost like a half and half page. Don't get so into the study help you forget that what is from the Lord is the text. But sometimes it helps. This is talking about just some archaeological finds that kind of explain where this book is in history, maybe where they got some of the ideas about interpretation from, whether it is Hebrew, Greek, or Aramaic, based on the culture of the day. So, these people are usually experts that translate word for word, unless it is paraphrased, meaning they translate for the meaning of that sentence. Here's another one. This is called the Jesus Bible, and it's just kind of a baby blue. It's got all kinds of little inserts for helping you understand what you're reading. And again, you got to remember that may or may not be divinely inspired as the holy text itself. I like to think that these people who add these things in are prayerful, and these are Louis Giglio. It says, with exclusive articles from Louis Giglio, Max Lucado, John Piper, Ravi Zacharias, Randy Alcorn, and they lift up Jesus as the lead story of the Bible in every single book. So even if Jesus isn't mentioned, they explain to you who he is in that book anyway. So I think this is going to be a real interesting study help, and it includes a custom reading experience on YouVersion. That is a Bible online, and I don't want to leave that out. Online Bibles are great, like Bible apps like YouVersion. There's all kinds of Bible apps, but YouVersion is the one I use, and you can use it in church because, you know, it when it comes on, it's a black background with white writing, so it doesn't shine when you're in church, and it makes it easy to find it when the pastor's preaching. He's not doing a Bible study usually. He's teaching on a subject, and so he may throw out a scripture here and there, and you may not have time to look it up while he's trying to talk. They'd be better just to hit John 3:16 and be there than to be flipping pages. So I think it is good to have an electronic Bible for church. Certainly you can take yours with you. I miss taking one, but I do lose time when I'm flipping pages. So generally speaking, my Bible study time is not during church, and that's when I really get into the Bible itself. Here's the other thing, something to write on. If I'm going to teach somewhere, I have a nice looking one. This is a Brahmin, but really inside all it is tablets, and it keeps my reading notes. If I've got a certain subject matter that I want to focus on for myself, like hope, and I want to keep it, you know, in its own little booklet. This is just a pretty little one from Baltic Club. I got it at a little gift shop. It's pretty. It's, you know, marbleized with rose gold, and it's kind of nice, but, you know, it's short. It's not big. So this will probably be a subject matter little notebook that I have. This other one is more for when I'm speaking on a particular subject or two. And then just for ongoing Bible study now, I have a larger one. This is from Farm Girl Journals, and I got this off of Etsy. And it's a very cool Bible journal in that it, hold on, let me get to, this is 1 Corinthians 7. So, and it says date, like what date you're doing it, scripture, who, what, when, where, why, and how. And you don't have to answer every one of them, but sometimes it just kind of gets you going to kind of think through what you're, the scripture that you're focused on. Who is the who in this story? What is the what in this story? When was this story? Where was this story? Why are you reading about it? Or why do you think God wrote about it? So, and then it also has a place in the back, I think, or just some pages where you list praises to God, thanks to God. Maybe you can do prayer requests and when he answered, because it's good to remind ourselves on stuff like that. And then, you know, sometimes we forget all that God's done for us, so it's good to go back and reference that. It also has a little, just a little plastic envelope in the back that I've got some tabs that I might put on this to divide it up into, you know, different things. And then also, these are the sermon notes from church. They do hand out a program, and I write notes as I go. And then sometimes I bring them back home so I can do Bible study. So I'll put them in the back thinking, okay, I want this particular one. I'm going to go in deeper with that. So that's another good tool. Then also, having a devotional is good to have handy. Here's two that I like. Y'all know that I'm very big on The Jesus Calling by Sarah Young. This is the desk version. There's a smaller version about this size that's downstairs right now. But the difference is the desk version is a little bit larger font. It's still just, you know, whatever is in the smaller size, which is usually a paragraph or so. And instead of just saying John 11:25 in the small version, in this version it actually types out the full scripture. So it makes it where you don't have to have a Bible handy because it's already listed out. The other one you have to have a Bible handy. But I'm not sure I want to get too much into not, if, especially in devotion time, not having the Bible right there with me. But it does make it easy if I'm in a hurry and I want to be able to read that scripture and refer to it. It's right there. So again, that's one. Here's another one. This is a youth one, but I use it. Matt Lucado's One God, One Plan, One Life. It's a 365-day student devotional, and his starts off with a scripture at the top, and then it's got some thoughts about it, and then just kind of a takeaway question to make you think and go further on it. And then also, I highly encourage you to get maybe some sort of a Bible study workbook. You can use them for life groups or Bible study groups, but also you can just do it for yourself. If you're like, well, what do I study? Well, pick one that speaks to you in the store, and a Christian bookstore, even places like Barnes & Noble and Books A Million and other places like that have a religious section or a Bible section. And usually you'll see study helps of all kinds, whether it's devotionals or Bible study handbooks. And usually they nowadays have videos where you purchase that. I don't know that you have to, because like I didn't on this one. I'm still just using the note pages just to guide myself through just some Bible study time with the Lord right now. So did I go over? I did. That's okay. I will make it two parts. I was going to try to get it into one part, but I don't want to rush it. So I think it's good as a Bible study tool to actually, if you want to, get a pre-done one. And then also a tote. Actually, we didn't go into two yet. So here's the tote. And also highlighters. You don't have to have this many, but highlighters and pens are good to have with you. And maybe even a whiteout. And maybe your tote is something that can hold everything, or just your Bible and a notebook.